Criminal Minds has been one of the most popular shows for the past 14 years. It's hard to imagine that the actors actually had quite different lives before it, but they definitely did. Someone had been dreaming of acting since childhood, and someone almost devoted their life to baseball. While one was sure acting was their vocation, another one had their doubts before starring in Friends. Watch our video and find out what the Criminal Minds stars were doing before the show. Kirsten Vangsness, aka Penelope Garcia. Over 15 seasons, the Criminal Minds sweetheart has played in and even co-written two of the hardest-hitting episodes of the series. Kirsten Vangsness was a shy little girl who got bullied through her childhood years. The actress channeled that experience into pursuing her dream of acting. Beginning in theater, Vangsness moved to commercials before finally landing her role on Criminal Minds, a character who was added to the show after her one episode shot. Kirsten became a part of it by accident. Her father did a lot of performing in community shows, and Kirsten and her sister would play background characters. Kirsten revealed, though, that her sister would often play teenagers, and she would be the 70-year-old woman. She thinks it's because she was odd and shy, and also got bullied a lot. Kirsten says she basically stopped talking in the 8th grade, and that's why her parents made her take acting classes. "I was really scared, but the first few assignments were just sort of pantomiming, so I didn't have to talk. At the time, I hadn't gotten an A in anything, but I kept getting A's in this class. It became something I knew I wanted to do, but I couldn't do it for a living. I didn't give myself permission to do it for a very long time. I just knew when I started in plays that I wanted to do this for the rest of my life. But I guess it would be Criminal Minds. That's when I was like, oh wow, they pay me to do this? I mean, I had other gigs, but this is the show where it really hit me. I had already been acting and going to auditions for probably 13 years. Joe Mantegna, aka David Rossi. According to Joe Mantegna, he knew what he wanted to be since his last years of high school when he auditioned for his part in the West Side Story musical. In the early 1970s, Joe Mantegna met playwright David Mamet at Chicago's Organic Theater Company, and that marked the beginning of a long and fruitful collaboration. Mantegna won a Tony in 1984 for his performance in Mamet's Pulitzer Prize-winning Glengarry Glen Ross, and later appeared in several of the writer-director's films. He's also been the voice of Fat Tony from the cult show The Simpsons for more than 25 years.
"Down like a crooked boxer. Selma, in this Matos Fedata world, you've got to hold on to the good thing."
After parts in such films as The Godfather Part 3 and Searching for Bobby Fischer, Mantegna made his directorial debut in 2001 with Mamet's Lake Boat. He was awarded 3 Emmy nominations before joining the cast of Criminal Minds. Before getting to the show, he was looking for some continuity in his career. His friend Dennis Franz told him, "If you get a chance to do a series, Joe, do it. You're gonna like working like we used to at the theater company, where you have the same group of people and there's a familiarity, as long as you get lucky and get a group you really feel good about." He was right. "If there's a downside, it's nothing obvious to me. There's something to be said for the fact that I can come home at night 9 months out of the year to my house and kids. I know what it's like not to do that." Shemar Moore, aka Derek Morgan. In high school, Shemar Moore excelled at baseball. He said he could hurl a fastball at 93 miles per hour and was drafted by both the Red Sox and the Baltimore Orioles, but his mother encouraged him to get a college education first. "Absolutely," Moore's mother recalls. He was not going to complete college without having at least one degree. Moore ended up at Santa Clara University on a baseball scholarship and majored in communications and minored in theater and arts. He wanted to pursue broadcast journalism. To pay his bills, he started modeling. Tendonitis in his arm and knee began hampering his baseball skills. "Little by little, I was making strides in the model commercial side," says Moore, whose ads appeared in catalogs for Macy's, Sears, and International Mail. He began the transition from model to actor. His big breakthrough? Playing Malcolm Winters on The Young and the Restless for 8 years. That opened other doors. In such films as The Brothers and Diary of a Mad Black Woman, acting had him hooked. 10 years ago in an interview, he said, "The soap opera was high school. I graduated. Now I'm in college with Criminal Minds. In a couple of years, I will graduate from Criminal Minds, and hopefully that will be the start of a long, long film career." Well, that's how it turned out. Shemar really left the show, but right now he's starring in a different show, SWAT. Matthew Gray Gubler, aka Dr. Spencer Reid. While Dr. Reid was an academic prodigy, Gubler was a prodigy of arts, gaining the right to attend a grade school for the arts called Las Vegas Academy after his auditions. Matthew's education has been highly focused on the arts. He started his career by being a fashion model. He worked as a model with DNA Model Management for Tommy Hilfiger, Marc Jacobs, and American Eagle. After he started modeling, Gubler had an internship with Wes Anderson, who encouraged him to audition for a part in his movie The Life Aquatic with Steve Zissou. Gubler did, and landed the role of Nico. This then led in 2005 to his leading role as Dr. Spencer Reid in Criminal Minds. It was really when the show started that I got into it. I did filmmaking, and through a roundabout manner, I got into this. I was 25 when the show started. Matthew also revealed that his friends and relatives are upset that he is in the show, because it wasn't what he set out to do. He also confessed that he is hoping to be directing movies or writing them. Paget Brewster, aka Emily Prentiss. Paget was always in plays, sang in Glee Club, formed a band, and even failed out of Paron's School of Design. Then this talk show in San Francisco started. Paget reveals, "Prior to that, I didn't realize that agents were different and represented different types of people. I was bartending and an agent hung out at my bar. I finally convinced him to represent me, but he represented correspondents and acre people. So I ended up going on auditions to get a talk show and ended up doing 55 episodes. Then I moved to Los Angeles and got an acting agent, and that was just lucky, really." Paget did 6 episodes of Friends, and that was an incredible break for her. She says it was probably the most exciting thing for her, and also the one that made her say, "Okay, I can do this for a living." Thomas Gibson, aka Aaron Hotchner. Before his professional training for performing arts, as a child, Thomas had always had a flair for drama. At the age of 9, Thomas Gibson had appeared in children's theater and also made an appearance in Seize the Street, the skateboard musical, produced by the Charleston Stage Production Company. His first foray into television was in 1987 in CBS's legal drama Legwork. Over the years, his career trajectory has been somewhat upward, with plenty of impressive performances. Back in 2005, Gibson was cast in the role as Supervisory Special Agent Aaron Hotchner, the unit chief of the BAU team. Thomas Gibson has been dismissed from Criminal Minds, ABC Studios and CBS Studios said in a statement. "I love Criminal Minds and have put my heart and soul into it for the last 12 years," Gibson said. He added, "I had hoped to see it through to the end, but that won't be possible now." Do you want to find out why he was fired? Watch our video about why the stars of Criminal Minds have left the show. Aisha Tyler, aka Dr. Tara Lewis. Before her start in the series, Aisha Tyler was known for the show The Talk. And when she was brought to Criminal Minds as a regular, the actress decided to leave The Talk, explaining that she has too much work. Stating the obvious, she noted, "I also have 3 other series, including Criminal Minds, where she's been upped from guest to regular, Whose Line Is It Anyway, which she hosts, and the animated Archer, on which she voices a character. People always go, how do you do all that? And I don't always have an answer," she said, adding quickly that participating on The Talk is such a joy that it never feels like work to me. Tyler started as a stand-up comic in the late 90s, at a time when, she says, black women were often pigeonholed into a specific style of comedy, while she was much more comfortable joking about her love of all things geeky. She followed that up with a hosting gig on Talk Soup, and from there, her career took off and keeps flying high. "I was gonna be a lawyer or something, but I was unhappy in my day job and felt like I wanted to do something creative. Stand-up was the only thing where you didn't need to know anybody or have an agent or get booked for. You could just go do it. And I thought I would just try it and see if I liked it." AJ Cook, aka JJ. As for AJ, she's been dreaming of dancing since childhood. A dancer from age 4, she began taking tap, jazz, and ballet lessons. For many years, she'd been dancing competitively, but then at the age of 16, she decided she wanted to try acting. Cook also taught dance when she was younger, and has stated that if she hadn't become an actress, she would probably set up a small dance studio. Cook's first job was a McDonald's commercial. Before Criminal Minds, she starred mostly in TV movies, so the show was a big breakthrough for her. Remember when the show decided to make cost-cutting measures by letting Cook go? Oh, JJ fans were upset. And so she was quickly brought back as a series regular, and is still on the show. "It felt like a breakup with a guy. It happened out of nowhere," Cook told TV Guide of her brief exit. After 7 days of negotiations, AJ Cook has just closed a 2-year deal to return to CBS's Criminal Minds as a regular. Comment who your favorite character is. Thanks for watching. Did you enjoy the story? Subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out on new thrilling videos about your favorite celebs.